No changes on either side. Everton will be hoping to continue as they did in the first half. Liverpool surely will be hoping to create rather more. There's been little penetration and they've been outplayed in the middle of the field. They've also managed to be caught too often at the back by Cotty. Good vision from Ward, picks out Vigri. Cotty coming in from the far side, Vigri goes for the shot. And he turns in disappointment. But the odds were against him. He didn't look up. He was trying to beat a world-class goalkeeper on the near angle of post and crossbar. Cotty, once again, found himself not really marked. Walters. Redknapp. Used the space well. Good interception by Ablett. But at least there was some pace and drive from midfield then. And that's the way that Nigel Clough likes the ball to be knocked up so he can play off to the supporting player. McManaman. Mark Wright has remained up. Here comes Whelan. Very similar position. On the position from which Mark Ward scored. But no true comparison with the shots. Given away, gets it back again. Who says there's not fraternal greetings in this match? Cotty. He was looking for the shooting chance himself, thought that he was balked. I think the referee did play an advantage, but Ebrel trying for the side foot into the top corner didn't quite get it right. But again, it's Everton. They're so busy in midfield and positive with their running forward. Here's Vigri. Cotty, it's too long. Ball, Redknapp, first touch for Rosenthal, and still not a good clearance by Horn. Bit of pressure suddenly from Liverpool. Nicol Schnappel did well. I think that his view must have been slightly obscured by Ablett, and it may be that Ablett actually got a bit of a touch on the ball. Yes, he did. Looking Howard Kendall must be a little bit concerned that his side have been wasteful with the opportunities. Too short, too many changes of mind. Redknapp. Clough. Rush. Oh, some good Liverpool pressure here. And stop. Julian Dix, who hit the shot, curled away, and Southall took no chances. Liverpool pressure certainly growing. Rosenthal having an early try on both sides. Four for the cross. Rush at the back. Trick in by Redknapp. Good save, Southall. With midfield players getting forward. Not what happened in the first half. It's happening now. And Southall having to match Bruce Gromelhoff. Rosenthal. Rosenthal once more from Dix. Rush! Just couldn't come in on it. He had to try and climb. And it hit him almost as much as he hit it. Second substitute for Liverpool. Steve McManaman, the man to be replaced. The action for the first time this season comes Paul Stewart. Clark not climbing the jump. To Preki. Holmes, right out, blocked by Mark Wright. Cotty, still Cotty, still Cotty, and still Cotty. Oh, the joy of it for him and for the Everton supporters. Seemed to have lost it, mixed up between two defenders. He was past Wright. Gromelhoff got a little bit of it. Wright got a little bit of it. Not quite. The toe poke was enough. And Tony Cotty, who has waited since 1989 to be in the starting lineup of a match between Everton and Liverpool, scores his fifth goal of the season and his first league goal against the team across Stanley Park. Scored twice in that 4-4 cup tie. A vibrant Liverpool derby is won by Everton, by Ward and by Cotty. The forcing of heart and nerve and sinew was beyond all reasonable expectations. And the home crowd delighted that the Blues have won the day.
We started well, we dominated the first half. We really should have had more goals, and that's been our problem this season up to now, when we haven't really taken as many chances as I would have liked. But in terms of domination, in terms of, you know, the will to win, we win in the first ball, we won't win the first ball, we win the second ball, and there's a lot of quality out there.
The lads played really well first half, and we were on top. Just thought we needed the second goal to kill the game off, and it didn't come. And the second half, they had a couple of chances, you know, and Rushy had a chance at a far stick. But when Tony's goal went in, that was it.
That was sheer persistence,
yeah,
wasn't it?
Yeah, it was, yeah. That's a Tony Cotty goal for you.
Two little fellas on the score sheet when everybody was talking about the beef that was around.
Well, I think that's all hyped up, really. I've played with Julian at West Ham, and Neil Ruddick is a good player, physical player, and they're the type of games that derbies are, the physical games.
So, Julian, what's a Liverpool derby like then?
Very quick, very aggressive. I enjoyed it most of all. Obviously, apart from the result, but I did enjoy it.
Did you expect it to be really as quick as that?
Not really. I expected it to be quick, but that was lightning. That was 100 miles an hour all the time. Actually, I'm as pleased as the fans are, even more so, believe it or not.
Yeah, I do believe that, actually.
Yeah, well, it's been a long day. It's been a rewarding one.
Of the win, which is always very important, it was the manner in which it was achieved. I mean, it was virtual domination, and that hadn't happened very often, and, you know, dominating the 90 minutes. or nearly the 90 minutes. I mean, that hadn't happened very often recently against Liverpool, or I mean, for that matter, I mean, not many people do against Liverpool. So it was pleasing. I mean, we won tackles in the middle of the park. I mean, we got the early goal, and then Tony Cotty finished it off in the end to make it 2-0. But no, it was very pleasing.